Alright, so we're going to fix that heatsink problem first. So we've got the back panel of the Wii that actually has all the screw points for these things. And we're going to want to salvage these four posts and these two posts. I think right now I'm just going to cut this all out in one piece. And if we need to make it separate pieces later, we can, and we can trim it to size later. So we'll just mark it out really loosely with the China marker here. Interesting question. If any of you people know why this thing is called China marker, let me know. Because it's something that I don't know and I've always wondered about, but I've never bothered to look up. So if any of you people actually know,
I think I know.
You think you know?
I think I know.
What is it?
So you know when you take things apart, sometimes there's like...
Why do you sound like you're from Minnesota? You are
not
from Minnesota.
So when you take things apart, you know how when like they come from like a big factory, sometimes they have writing on the inside of them with that grease pencil?
Yeah.
I think that's why.
So you think it's called a China marker because it's commonly used in China to mark the inside of things?
Sure.
I mean, that's a better reason than I've come up with. I doubt that's the right reason. So, if you guys know the right reason, let me know. And if she's right, let me know, and I will give her a special reward. Yay. So, anyway, what we've got here is my coping saw, which I haven't actually used before, because I've never had blades for it. My dad gave me this, and he just like, I don't need it, take it. So I took it. So I'm not 100% sure how this works. So bear with me. I'm probably going to look like an idiot if you guys know how these things work.
Do you want some help?
And if they don't, then you guys will learn with me. Okay, cool. So, looks like the handle just loosens up. It has a nice long stretch there. Clip it in the top, clip it in the bottom. And then you kind of hang on to this guy while you tighten it back up. In case any of you guys need to know how to use a coping saw later on. I mean, granted, it's not going to take a rocket scientist to figure this out, but it's cool. So let's give this a whirl. I don't know how this works. So I've seen on jeweler's saws before, they have these little fork things that come out, hang off the table, and I thought about getting something like that, and I was like, I don't need that. Apparently I do actually need that. Let's try the crumb cover, because it actually sticks out a little further. Definitely the wrong way to do this, but man, this is actually kind of fun. Yay! And it's out. Okay, so here's one of the reasons we're having some trouble. This is like super, super thick, double layered plastic. Good job, Nintendo. This thing is super, super, super sturdy. Okay, so we back over here. I could probably split this out, make this just that much thinner. Haha. Okay, so things we could have known and saved ourselves some time. This inner panel on the back of the Wii, how it looks like there's actually a second panel recessed in there. There is. It's just glued in very, very well, so you can't normally pop it out. But this is very strong adhesive tape. You actually can take that off. I don't know why you ever would, but you can. Last video, my camera cut off probably about an hour before I actually finished what I was shooting. Somewhere between 45 minutes and an hour. So we lost a lot of footage over what we did between that last shot, which you should have just seen, and what we're doing right now. So things that we finished in that video that it missed, we got the backplate finished and mounted. We have the heatsink shroud mounted along with the fan. Had to mock up some washers out of the old shroud cover that was there to make it fit right, because the screws were too long to screw in without the plastic shroud there as well. We modified the frame. You'll notice the frame looks a little bit different than it did in the last few shots. We took out all this intermediate hardware because we had to get the slider off of here, the part that it actually was going up and down to move the toaster racks in the outer sleeves up and down. That was in the way of pretty much everything, so we had to get rid of that. And in doing so, that got rid of all the cross members here. But this all still functions just the same, except that I pulled the spring out apparently. We still get that same action there. I was using that to test fit, putting plastic down here to save the, so the drive would sit it better. We got the rough mountings for the board and drive figured out. So basically we're gonna end up like this. The main board will go about here. And I have some mock-up spacers to go in here as well, made from some foam. But basically it's gonna space out about that far away on top and bottom. Basically the board will sit there, and the drive up against this plate was putting this drive too far off center to be able to actually use the disk drive. So we had to knock out a cutout here. We just took the coping saw and hacked it out. And then the drive actually aligns properly about there. And again, spaced out a little bit. So it'll be something like that far away. I have checked the ribbon cable. The ribbon cable does just reach that with the alignment changed up like that. But that's essentially what our guts are going to look like. So we figured out the final placement. These are exactly where these are going to go. But I haven't figured out exactly how I'm securing them yet. That's probably what we're going to do today. Oh, also, the ribbon cable here, you can probably tell there's a giant piece of pink duct tape on it. The way that the ribbon cable is angled and the way that it actually attaches to the board mean that we are going to have to actually tape it down while we're assembling it. Once it's in, it's not stressed enough to be fine, but to reach it around to the angles it needs to go to, it just keeps popping up because it's one of those simple flap cables, so you flip the piece up and then snap it down. So if you pull tension on it this way at all, it just pops right open. So we're going to have to tape it down while we're assembling. And we're just gonna leave the tape in there, it's not gonna hurt anything. We also figured out how we're going to do the eject and Bluetooth sync buttons. You can see we've reattached the slider down here, and I've mapped out its full range of motion, so it can go all the way this far with the shroud on, and all the way this far that way with the shroud on. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put contact points on those lines, so that when you move this over, it's gonna make contact and, think of the side that way would be eject. And if you slide that way and hold it, it'll be your Bluetooth sync. That's the first thing we're gonna do today. Possibly get that wired up. So basically what we're gonna do is I found this. This is the piece of the shroud that originally went here on the Wii. But this opening here is almost exactly the same measurement as this distance here. So what we're gonna do is take this piece, cut it down to fit in this gap, and then screw it down to the metal there, and then we're going to mount contact points to this arch so that when this comes over and hits it, it'll make contact. Now we can't just use the metal here because those two switches don't connect to ground. So we have to make sure that it's insulated away from ground, but also wired to where they need to go. So what that means is we're gonna have to come up with some kind of solution for this guy so that we can have wires attached to it, most likely running along the underside. Looks like there's plenty of room down there to get literally two wires past it. So the wires just travel with it. And then we'll just have some sort of open contact to hit the metal plates we're gonna be putting on here. And then those metal plates will wire up and run back to their solder points on the front. Also on the agenda today is to wire up this end of the power supply, the power switch rather, so that when you actually hit these contacts, you turn the power on. Shouldn't be terribly difficult, just have to do it. So we'll get there. Let's get started. Trim back on this side a little more because it is actually hitting the post there and we don't want it to hit the post. I guess we should see how the depth works there. Yeah, see that's essentially what our function is going to be. It's going to come over, hit here, make electrical contact with the pieces we haven't made yet, and we'll be good to go. Come over here, do the other function. But we do need to trim this back just a smidge, so. It's always good to make sure the concept works as you're working, because it really sucks to have a great idea and it just not work at all. So. One of the nice things about mods like this is, while it's nice to have it pretty on the inside, no one's ever going to see the inside after it's done, so it doesn't have to be pretty. Alright, so that's our mounting points. We're going to be going there to there, so as close to that centering as we can find. Not there, I guess. Okay. I'm going to throw a little bit of tape on here to hold it in place, and then we're going to drill some holes in it and throw some bolts in it. All right, you usually want to get a little center punch going of where you're going with these screws. I don't have anything really planned out for this, I'm just going to kind of go for it. So my real goal is just get it far enough over that it won't break this thing all the way down, because that would suck. Cut it out, see if it's the right dimensions, I guess. Another semi-pro tip, slow down when you get to the end of snipping with 10 snips, or you're gonna have to chase your work across the room. Didn't learn that today, but that's something I've learned. And this is about the same size as these guys here too, right? Yeah, we can drill it out just a little bit and it'll work. So if we do that, just kind of go to the end there. We still have a head we can screw off of there. Cut this guy about in half and we can do the same thing on the other side. And then for here, we can just glue or have this putty stuff that works pretty well as a general adhesive. Just glue the contact down because these things aren't going to be high impact or anything. So that manner of, you could almost get away with taping it, except that tape decays so much over time, it would eventually just stop working. So, but I think the putty should be fine. I don't remember what brand it is, like Loctite or something. I was walking through the store and saw it, and I'm like, that's awesome, I can use that. Don't know for what, but I can use it for something. And now we know for what. Let's go ahead and get these screws opened up a little bit, these holes opened up, to accept the same size screw, and we'll go ahead and pop a screw in from the back side before we glue it down. This is going to be dangerous. Just give me one of those, don't try this at home, kids. Right in time for my lady to walk in the room and watch me doing this very unsafely. Say hi. You're not saying hi.
Hi. Don't die.
It's totally safe.
Don't die.
Don't do this ever. The reason I can safely say don't do this ever is because I have definitely had one of these come off and nearly chop my finger off, and I've had one come loose and drill through my finger, and don't do it. It's not worth it, unless you're me and you're impatient. And even then, it's not worth it. It's just, I just don't care. That's not really right. I do care about getting injured, but there's not many injuries I could get from that I can't patch up myself, so. Oh, I'm getting a look right now, that's fantastic.
Baka Dad just likes going to the hospital.
I mean, I don't enjoy it, but it happens. And it's not like I go there often enough that they know my name or anything, so.
Of course not, because we moved. It's not the same hospital.
Yeah, I mean, that's true, but. Alright, so that's what we're going to do here. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to take this, wrap the wire around it, and then tighten another nut to the back side to sandwich it in. That way we don't have to worry about soldering to this, what I'm assuming is aluminum for how easy that's working. Could be aluminum, could be stainless steel, I don't actually know. In that thin of a gauge, it's kind of hard for me to tell. I'm not a metallurgist by any means.
I'm gonna buy you some toy bins from your workroom.
Toy bins? Oh, yeah. Throw all my crap in, yeah.
It works with the baby.
It's a little messy in here.
So, I just realized, just now, that World of Warcraft is called World of Warcraft because it's the open world story version
of Warcraft. Right. You really didn't know that?
No.
Wow.
I was flying to Ogrimmar and I'm like, wait a minute. This is open world Warcraft.
Yes, it's the world.
Kind of.
It is the world of Warcraft. Imagine that, the world of Warcraft is in fact the world of Warcraft. You're awesome, dear. Thank you.
I'm gonna go now.
Alright.
Stay away from the voodoo.
Stay away from the voodoo.
Shall thou shall worry.
Light be with you. Look, tar friend. Oh Lord, sorry, just kind of nerded all over the place there. All right, so that's what we're going for. I don't know how well you can see it. I'm going over here and see. Wow, this lighting is terrible over here. Ah. Okay, so we've got metal plate glued to there. And in theory, that should work. Definitely in theory, though. But my theories are usually correct. I'm pretty smart. Don't always have the best decision-making skills, and I don't always do things correctly, but I am pretty smart. Okay, so that'll go in there. Last guy will come in here. And we'll go click. That's even better. Okay, I should have it aligned because of the putty in there. Alright, so we do have to figure out how to mount something to that still to make contact with that. That's the next bridge across. Let's finish this one first. Alright, more unsafe drilling. Again, disclaimer, do not do this ever. Plan comes together. I hope that's not trademarked. I just remember that's what the guy from the A-Team says, like, as I said that. So. Wasn't intentional, guys. Don't sue me. Oh, Lord. Somebody eventually is going to flag me for copyright for something that I'm not intentionally doing. I don't know if I'm just paranoid about that or what, but... So if we get this done in a reasonable amount of time, we're actually going to get to do some soldering today. That's exciting. And if not, we'll do it tomorrow. Which will be in the same video for you, but just means more work for me. Okay. I guess it's not technically more work if I'm doing the same amount of work, but I digress. So we'll go ahead and just get them on for now. I just kind of leave them there loose. But those will keep that in place well enough. So now we need to get our depth on this guy, where these are going to hit. So this makes contact on a whole bunch of places, anywhere from here to here. It's like anywhere along there. This guy. Huh, that's interesting. So the head of the screw actually was acting like a stop, so they would get here, and you have to like force it over another bit to hit contact. Oh, I hope that's not touching. Oh, that's not good. We don't want this to touch ground, so that's a problem. We need to fix that before we go forward. I'm thinking we just squeeze it with the pliers and rearrange the angle. Oh, so I guess the plastic did crack there, and I guess we will, in fact, be securing this with hot glue, because this screw now has to come out, because it's going to be grounded against this, and this whole piece is going to have to hot glue in, so hope you guys like that I'm leaving in when I screw things up like this, because it makes the channel feel more honest to me. Because like on the blog, I could just skip over where I horrifically mess something up and nobody knows the better of it. But on camera, when you can actually see every step of the way, you're gonna go, well, hey, why did that skip and why is this thing now covered in hot glue? Well, now you know. So we're gonna run grab my crappy little hot glue gun, get it plugged in, and then once it's charged back up, we'll be back. So yeah. All right, we're back. The hot glue gun is heated up and we're ready to get started. So we're just gonna put this back where it was, more or less, and we're just gonna go for it. Alright, so just had the thought that we should probably make sure these guys, the screws on the front, aren't going to interfere with the front cover. So let's do that, and I can also show you what that's going to look like through the slot, because it's pretty cool. Oh yeah, yeah, we got plenty of room. So yeah, there's plenty of room in here to get all that done. No problem at all. That's not wanting to go in all the way, but that's fine because it's because of the nut here. All right, bring it all the way through to there. All right, so we're gonna be looking like this. We're gonna go this way for one mode, which is probably gonna be eject, and that will be Bluetooth sync. Power. Yeah, cool stuff. I'm getting excited. Once we figure out how to get the actual machine mounted in here, we'll be in really good shape. Okay, that's going to be more secure once we get that nut secured, so that's fine. All right, so I was working on how to actually make the contacts with the slider, because again, we can't use the actual slider because it's grounded, and we do not want that touching ground, because that could be very, very bad. So what I did was I marked where this actually contacts the plates. And what we're gonna do is I found this piece of wire, which was from the power originally on this toaster. And we're gonna basically use it to make the contacts with. So what we're gonna do is, we have more room on top or bottom? Definitely more room on top. Okay. So we're gonna glue this guy to the top here, past this thing, because that's actually what contacts the bar here to make it slide more slowly. So we don't wanna interfere with that. So we're gonna hot glue this guy on here, and it's gonna be our insulator to keep these wires off of there. And then basically we're just gonna wire one up that way, one up the other way, the lead's going off in opposite directions, hot glue them down, and then we'll solder to the wire that we're going to split in half, and then solder to that wire, the wires that are actually running to the console. So. Thank you. it tentatively set. Let's make sure we have a good electrical connection. Alright, go to this guy here. Hitting. Now we're not. So if we slide the switch over. Nice momentary switch there. Beautiful. So now we'll lock that into place with some more glue. Let's just let that sit and solidify. And we'll come back to that in a minute. So the other thing on the agenda today is wiring up the power switch. So I have these guys, which were from the heater, which already had the nice little screw holes shaped onto them. I'm just gonna snip these clean and reuse these wires because it's easier. And again, with these, I'll probably be snipping them off and soldering good wire to them and running the good wire. But these actually came from here. These are what was hooked here originally. So what we need to do is we need to find a way to patch these back two pieces together electrically. I think we just shove something in there and patch between the two and it'll be good enough. This is literally just a momentary switch saying, hey, turn the power on. It's not like it actually has current going through it or anything, so. I keep saying it's the power, but in reality, it's just the power switch. It's not like the original toaster design where it's running 110 through this thing. It's running like a couple of volts at most in the milliamp range, and this should be just fine. So, okay, let's see if we got electrical connection there. Oh, I'm so sorry. I feel like I'm letting you guys down for doing terrible electronics work here, but it is what it is. All right, so let's go with the top contact. So basically, we want to test if these wires or the switch will make this bridge across now. So we'll just screw my leads into it. Oh, this is terrible. This is bad electronics. You guys should not do this. I'm just tired and having fun at this point. Like, the end product will be functional, yes. That's all that I am actually concerned about at this point. I'm not concerned about trying to use this on my resume or something for electronic engineering, because this is definitely not electronic engineering. This is screwing around. Haha! You hear that? It works. That's what counts. This is really, the toaster project here is really more of a curiosity and conversation piece. It's not like I'm actually gonna be using this thing every day or anything. Like, it's gonna be more of a display piece, talking point when it's finally done, which makes it fall actually into like the art category more so than electronics, but toasters aren't really art. Well, I'm sure there's someone that has toaster art, and I'm sure they're fantastic at it. But I am not that person. Alright, so, ready to attach the power leads. Alright, so that's our power switch done. I think what we're probably going to do is on the main board. Main board goes this way, power switch is here. What we're probably going to do is go ahead and solder on the wires for these separately. And then once we've got this in place, then manage the cables back around and then make the actual final solder to the connectors. That way we don't have to worry about this thing, these two pieces being attached until they're physically attached. There's a few other things you guys missed that I just remembered. The memory card slot. I've decided this is not my only Wii. I have another Wii hooked up to my big TV in the living room, as well as a GameCube that is region modified to play any of my Japanese stuff. So I don't actually need the GameCube functionality on this thing, but I do still want access to the GameCube ports to do the GameCube controllers. Because there's a lot of games on the Wii that do support that, and they're generally pretty good games. So we're going to make sure that functionality is there. But we're not actually going to use the GameCube ports at all, because they're only used when the GameCube firmware is booted, when it's in that mode. And I don't intend on ever putting it in that mode. So no harm, no foul. Is that even appropriate here? I don't actually know what that means, honestly. But I do know the Switch works. We're going to take this piece of plastic, which was from the outer shell of the Wii, and we're going to make a baseboard inside of this thing. That way we can use this to make more secure mounts for the bottom of the CD drive. We can use it to help support the actual PCB. Just give a whole new rigidity to the structure, I guess, is the word I'm looking for. This plastic is really, really malleable. It's quite nice, actually. Like, I would buy sheets of this plastic to work with because it's that much fun to work with. It's a great thickness. It's a good sturdiness. But it's also pliable, but super easy to cut. I don't know. I like it. So what I was looking at off camera was that this should fit up under here once we get it trimmed, and this should also fit here. So once we get the length cut here, we can just kind of pop it in and have a floorboard. I'm not sure if we can get it in. Yeah, we can. I can't put it into words, but just trust me, it's gonna work. Super solid platform which we can set the CD drive on, we can set the main board on, and really make it a lot more secure. I haven't worked it out yet, but on the top here, we did have some screws that came through the front here. If we can reuse those screw holes and it not interfere with the disc, then we may be able to run some screws out and maybe even into this bar here. So like, where's my awl? So we go through here like that, and then just use a longer screw to literally just hold it in place. That will probably be the absolute most secure way we can do this. So basically we'll use one of the long screws here, which I don't know if they'll fit in there or not. We are going to find out right now. These exact screws may not be long enough, but they do have long ones at the store. So I think what we're going to do is that we're going to do exactly that. We'll get some. These are, how long are you? Where's the other packaging at? So these are half inch. These are 3/4. I think what we're going to need is like an inch. Because that'll give us a little bit more through, and then we can bolt onto the back side. So basically the idea is We stick a machine screw through. We'll snug it up. Can you guys see this at all? Stick a machine screw through, snug it down to the board, like so. Like so. Then we'll drill a hole through the upper part, stick it through, and then basically put a third screw on here, or a third nut to set the stopping distance, and then another nut to actually secure it. So this will actually have three nuts on it when it's done. Which is why this definitely will not work with this size screw. We'll need something a little bit longer to get through there. But I really like that idea. That will be super, 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 super secure and adjustable, which is also important. All right. Sorry, I got cut off in the middle of my sentence here. Basically, need to buy machine screws. And that's very, very exciting because I was very worried about how to actually mount the drive more so than the board. Because the board fits in here very well as it is. I'm a little worried about cutting out the back panel, but we'll be doing that next time. That'll definitely be in part four. That won't be tonight. And even if I do it, I have too much to do before we get to that point, basically is what I'm trying to say. I'm kind of thinking, I know it sounds terrible, I'm kind of thinking we just hot glue this top edge here in, and then we make something similar bracket-wise on the bottom side down here. But that sounds so lazy, but that's really a great way to do this. I'm a little worried about the side-to-side movement here, so we'll need to do something about that. Probably just take some pieces of plastic and shore up against it and glue them down. I know it sounds terrible, but hot glue is your friend when you're making custom electronics that are showpieces more so than anything else. The Millennium Falcon N64 is a great example. If you haven't seen it yet, go check it out. It's on my blog. I'll put a card in the corner so you can see that. Go check it out on my blog. Took a Millennium Falcon toy and we put an N64 inside of it, and that thing is fairly rock solid stable, and that board is literally hot glued to the inside of it. There was no way to get screws inside of that Millennium Falcon without completely destroying the outside shell, so it was really our only option. We have more options here because it's a toaster, but more options doesn't necessarily mean better options. We need to test the slider switch. That's what's next. Because this hot glue should be dry by now. Very, very solid. I like it. And I can't see what I'm doing anymore because of that plastic piece, so we'll do. Like that. Okay. And then we just need to figure out what to do with these wires. So that part's done. We've got our, what I'm going to call our receiving ends, wired up. So next is desoldering some connectors and wiring some, hooking some wire up in their place, which is going to be a pain. Do I want to do that tonight? It's early. I don't have an excuse not to. So I'm going to take a short break. It'll be even shorter for you guys because I'm going to edit it. Get the soldering iron plugged up and let that get heated up and come back in. We'll start on that. So basically the game plan there is I'm going to try, I don't know if I can just go in the back sides of these, like, I'll grab the macro lens and show you guys a close up of this. That'll make a lot more sense than me just talking about these switches that you definitely can't see. Hang on. Alright, so this is my dental pick poking these things, so that should give you some idea of how small it is. My idea is we're going to go and hit, it's this switch and this one are wired together, and then this one is the one that's actually toggled. So we'll run one wire to there, and one wire to there, and there. We'll bridge both of those contacts just to make sure that it's switching correctly. This guy here is our reset. Decided to not do reset. There's really just no reason in modern gaming to need a reset button on your console. If I need to turn it off, I can turn it back on. I can just hold down the power button and force shut it off and do that. But these things are really, really tiny. Like this giant pick right here is my dentist pick I was just showing you in the last shot. It's super, super tiny. You see how big it looks in there. So a little worried about getting a secure solder to these joints without hitting the ground right beside of it. I want to do this without actually removing the original switches, just go in the backside and add on to it. Don't know if that's possible or not, so we'll see how that goes. Alright, here we go. This is super difficult because it's so tiny. That's what she said. Okay. It's very important this to be completely cool before I try to get to the next pin or before I try and move the wire. If it's not, it's going to be a terrible connection and it's not going to seat right. Also, I need to check continuity on both sides of that to make sure that there's not any crossover on the solder that I just can't see. Let me just get out of the way. Alright, so these two should be connected. And this should not be. Okay. And not cool. Okay. Alright, so that wire is isolated, that's good. It's not connected to the other pins, which means it's successful. Now very, very carefully, we need to do the one right beside of it, which this will be the more difficult of the two. Because we also need to make sure it doesn't hit the ground.
You can't see the thing.
What?
Your hand was in the way.
Sorry, this is...
I know.
I'll also try not to burn myself, that's the other key. Alright. I did pre-tin these wires to make this a little bit easier. I think I might be on the ground there, but I can't actually tell. So let's get the magnifying glass and find out. Doesn't look like it, and it looks like we're still isolated on the pins. So, that's not gonna work. Well, right, okay, so these will be connected right now because this is actually a loop of wire. So what we need to do is actually cut the loop and then test the continuity. It was just easier to measure out two lengths of wire by using a loop. So now they should not be connected. Meter on. So this does not connect to ground. Does connect to what it should, does not connect to what it should not. So, that was successful. Yay! Now we very, very carefully, can you see the spot on the board? So I pre-drew a few circles on the board of where it's safe to apply hot glue to. So what we're going to do is hold these wires down pretty far away from any of the electrical stuff on the board and just give a good, healthy slather of hot glue. To hold them in place while we're actually putting this together. If these wires move at all at that switch, they're going to snap off. It's just working with stuff this small and just surface level solder joints. It's how it works. I don't like it, but it is what it is. So we're just let that sit for just a minute and then move on to the next switch. Alright, so I just went ahead and knocked out the rest of these solder joints off camera just because the camera's having a really hard time seeing all these things. So basically what I've done is wired the power. Two wires are independent of each other. I made sure they're not touching at all. Hot glued it to the board. Bluetooth sync, same thing, glued to the board. And eject, same thing, glued to the board. And then I desoldered the LED switch, the LED socket for the front panel where the it talks to the disk drive. And I've run that along this little bitty cable. And then I soldered the jack to the end of it so that we can just use this like an extension cable. So we'll plug the the DVD LED into that, and it should work just fine. I'm gonna set the camera back on the tripod and we'll keep going.
Cool. So that's all good to go. Now we need to figure out how to get this into the toaster. It looks so cool with all the wires dangling off now. Looks like it's really starting to come together. We still have some pretty big obstacles to overcome as far as like getting the back panel cut out cleanly and all that kind of stuff, but we are getting there, guys. So, is there anything else we can do tonight? Let me think. We can't mount this yet because we don't have the long screws yet. We can't mount this yet because we have to make the template for the back panel, which I don't have the stuff to do, but I can go get because it's stuff that I have around the house. So I guess we'll make that template and I'll show you guys how I'm going to do that, and then in the next video I'll actually do that. This is the LED I was talking about, and that's literally the plug that came this plugged into originally, so it gives us plenty of room to get it back up there where it needs to go. Yeah, let's do this template. I'm gonna grab what I need to do to draw that out, and I'll show you guys how I'm gonna do that. We'll go ahead and see if my idea works, and I'm gonna unplug the soldering iron and the hot glue gun and let those guys cool off while I'm getting those things. So be right back. Alright, so to draw out the template for our connectors back here on the back, we're going to try to take a piece of paper, cover it up, and draw on it. Just kind of do that old scribbling thing you see in the movies where they're detectives copying down the important information. I haven't done this before, but I don't see why it won't work. I'm getting all the basic shapes that I need. I have the fans over here. And we've got USB ports. Okay. And then edge of board. Look at that. That actually worked out a little bit better even than I expected. I can actually see the impressions on it. Okay, so that's our basic design. What we can do is take this now inverted design, stick it on top of where the USB port actually goes, tape it down, and just go straight through. Like drill it out, and then go over the coping saw and clean it all up until it fits perfectly. The USB, I think, will be first because it's going to poke through up here in this orange section, which will be one of the thicker bits to get through. But I think it'll be fine. So I think we're going to stop here. We got a ton done today. I am super, super proud of this. This is really exciting. We could actually stick this in here and boot up the Wii
with these cables out like this, and that is very, very exciting. One other thing we have to figure out before I forget, we have to figure out how to mount the Wi-Fi module. So the Wi-Fi module plugs into the board here. And we'll find some way of heat sinking that. I'll figure that out between now and then. We gotta figure out where to put these guys, which are the Wi-Fi antennas. My current plan is non-existent, so I'm thinking short one hot glue to the front of the case, long one hot glue to the back of the case. There's plenty of room to do that on each side here. That's probably what we're going to do, actually. So if any of you guys know anything about Wi-Fi antennas and why that would be a bad idea, please, please, please let me know down in the comments, because I do not know anything about Wi-Fi antennas other than how they plug into the card and put them back where they came from, or so help me. Don't sue me, Disney, please. It's time to get to bed. Anyway, like the video if you liked it, dislike if you disliked it. As always, hit the subscribe button. There's lots more content to come. We may be able to wrap this up in the next video. We may not. I have no idea yet. But yeah, that's it for now, and we'll see you in the next one.